Hello and welcome back to the Nulyweds channel. I'm so excited to be bringing you our very first instalment of the wedding planning series. Today we are speaking to Tissy from the Elite Group Weddings and Events. She's going to be talking to us about how to get married in Puglia. All of her details are in the description box down below and pinned to the top comment. You don't want to miss this conversation. I've also split this conversation into sections so you can jump forward and backwards and refer to the bits that interest you the most. But I hope that you stay for the entire conversation because it is a really juicy one. I learned so much. But enough waffle, let's get into the conversation.
Right, so we are joined today by Tissy from the Elite Group. Welcome to the channel.
Thank you so much, Olivia. It's really great to be here.
So introduce a bit about yourself. Tell us a bit about yourself, your business, what you do, and how you do it.
My name is Tissy. I'm originally Dutch, living in Milano, in the suburbs, actually. I founded the Elite Group in 2015 in Dubai because of my great passion for hospitality, celebrating life with good food, with good people in a beautiful place, actually. Preferably with a glass of bubbly and some music in the background. I love traveling, discovering new places, and I found a love myself in Dubai with an Italian guy, and that made me in the end move to Italy and start my family here. We actually also have a two-year-old daughter, I have to add. So we're very happy in Italy. But and then we actually got married here in Puglia. My husband is from Puglia. And that's actually where I fell in love with planning my own wedding. And creating that experience for everybody. So with my background of having events and doing events in Dubai, I then started doing that here in Italy.
Lovely. Wonderful. So we're talking about Puglia today then. I've never been to Puglia. I've been to Italy once, so this will be super interesting for me to learn more about the region. Tell me why we should consider getting married in Puglia. Why would you recommend any couple get married there?
Well, I'm in love with Puglia, especially. I might be a little bit biased because my husband is from Puglia, but I feel Puglia is still a little bit of an underdog if you compare it with, for example, the more popular destinations like Como, Tuscany. The Amalfi Coast is very, very popular destination. But Puglia basically has it all. It has a beautiful coastline, it has the white sandy beaches, it has the green rolling hills, it also has a rocky coast. You see, for example, now very popular is also a destination like Capri, who has like the beautiful rocks in the water where they make all these picturesque Instagrammable photos. Well, Puglia has that too. It's still a little bit unknown, and it's so beautiful, and it's also very diverse. Food has a really big role, of course, everywhere in Italy. But I know that in Puglia, because it's still a bit rural, the biological products, as we're all hyped up about it now, it's been there for years. They don't know any better. It's still so farm to table. It's still so fresh produce. The amazing buffalo mozzarella, the fresh fish. I'm, for example, a huge oyster lover. So I've tasted a lot of oysters around the world, but there's like the beautiful oyster from San Michele in Puglia. They come very, very close to like the high quality oysters in France, for example.
Wow. So you'd say that maybe Puglia is very good on the gastronomical side, like for big foodies, that they would really, really like Puglia, even if they like Italian foods, like if Puglia specifically could be like a really great option for them.
Yes. Yes, that whole Dolce Vita style, what I really love and always like to bring out in our weddings. That the culture of dining and dancing and being under the sun and under people, and that whole vibe is definitely there. Yes.
And you touched on it being quite a rural place, like quite rural. Can it be a bit challenging to work and to have your wedding there because of the rural nature of it? Is there any specific challenges about getting married in Puglia?
Yes, well, I have to say the infrastructure is a little less maintained or developed as it is more up north. Puglia is quite a big region. It's just like the whole boot at the bottom at the south. There's two airports, so logistically wise there's good options, but you do have to keep in mind at least usually travel at least 1 hour to the locations that are noteworthy for having weddings. So it's not an extreme amount, but it's still, you know, something to keep in mind. Logistic wise, it really depends on your location. If you do have a hotel that is very on top of a rocky coast, you might have to keep in mind, you know, if you want to have a setup on the beach, how to get all your setups there. But I mean, in the end, they're more and more developing, especially around the bigger venues for weddings, that have all the logistics around them, all the suppliers around them, so that they can work with. But it can be a bit more challenging.
Okay, so in terms of the logistics of traveling, it can be quite lengthy, and maybe if people are coming from a long way, maybe America, for example, then they've got the long flight and then they've got a little bit of travel within the country as well, but nothing too tough. Is there anything else that you think would be challenging for a destination wedding couple?
I have to point out the language. There might be a little bit of a language barrier in terms of the more south you get, the less the English is developed. And that's not to say that you won't find venues, especially the bigger ones. Obviously, they always have a representative there that speaks English that can communicate with you, especially about, like, at least about bookings and these kind of things. But don't expect like full conversations, super detailed conversations, because that is where it gets a little tricky. So definitely, if you have somebody that could help you, you know, not get lost in translation, that would be ideal.
Yes. And that's what people like us are for. So
absolutely, yes, definitely. I do speak Italian fluently now, luckily. I had to, because my husband's family didn't speak a word of English either, so had to dive right in. Yeah, something else, as we have an expression here in Italy, that's it's called piano piano, which means basically slow it down, take it easy. That culture is absolutely much stronger in the south. They are not really in a rush. They don't really understand why we are always, especially North Europeans, are so strict with our timings, our timelines, we need to get bum 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 going. Yeah, they're a bit more slowed down. Photographers can miss an exit and then arrive half an hour later, and if you just had the window for half an hour of taking pictures, that might freak you out.
Yeah,
definitely, but as a couple as well. So those are things that, we always keep in mind and anticipate on, that you need to, like, if you can stretch your timings a little bit, have a little bit more patience and relax, then everything's gonna be fine.
I think that's a great tip. I think that if anyone is to schedule their wedding, when they're thinking about a wedding in Italy, maybe just factor in just, you know, 50% extra time, just in case, you know, the timeline is more of a guide than a strict thing. And weddings always kind of run over or under in certain areas anyway. It's always a little bit flexible. So that's something awesome bearing in mind. Thank you for that. So let's go back to the positive stuff. Lots of people want to get married in Italy and Puglia specifically because of the weather. It's in the south of Italy, so even better, right? So tell us when you would recommend getting married in Puglia.
Yes, well, I have to say, I guess nothing is as unpredictable as the weather. There's unfortunately no guarantees whatsoever, but I would recommend, I say, May and June to start with, and then September. July is definitely also an option, but you have to keep in mind that it's a lot warmer and can become very hot, so that is definitely recommended to do afternoon and evening. August I would avoid altogether, because that is high season. All Italians are off. They're always all off in August altogether. So most of the things are also like closed, like things around like stores and these things are more closed, but it's just all Italians. They go to the beach and everything's more busy, you know? So it's, yeah, it's something that I would definitely advise you to avoid. And then September is, it's a great Indian summer, like after the peak is over. Even would say beginning of October could still be good, but then again, you know, nothing is ever unpredictable. We got married on the 31st of August, and the whole town around us was rain and thunderstorms, and we were the only ones who had a dry spot. It was a miracle. But it, just to say that at end of August, yeah, in the middle of Puglia, you wouldn't expect any of that, but it's still, it's possible. It's the weather.
Well, that's so interesting. I was about to ask that. Is it like quite a dry region generally? Is it known to be quite dry, or is it, you know, just go through all of the seasons?
No, it's generally more dry. It's definitely more warm right now as well here in the north. It's obviously much colder in there, and the summer starts a lot earlier too. So even if you're thinking about spring weddings, April's absolutely fine. I mean, it's probably not going to be as hot. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to swim yet, but it's definitely a good weather and you have sunny days.
Nice.
We even had been there in December where it was like super sunny and beautiful, not as hot, but obviously, yeah, and weather wise it's a pretty safe zone.
Okay.
Yeah, never know.
Even better, like having a safe, you know, knowing that it's likely to be pretty good. I mean, yes, like we say, the weather is the weather. We can't control that. If we could, we really would as planners. But it's good to know that it's a relatively safe option. So scenario, okay. So let's say I'm engaged. I won't be for many years, but say that I am engaged. I want to get married in September. And I have around 50 guests or so. Right. How much do you think I would be anticipating to spend? What would you advise to me is a good budget for my wedding?
Well, that's a really good question. And I think something that most planners will tell you straight away is weddings are a very tailor-made experience. And what for one can be a very luxury wedding is for another maybe the standard, or you know, or even over the top. It doesn't it really depends on your couple and your vision. If I'd have to give a ballpark, and we speak in euros, right, I'd say the bare minimum is 25,000, but we start generally at 30 to 35 to make sure that we are in a good, we start in premium range anyways.
Lovely. So for like a wedding in your kind of style, in the way that you plan weddings and the way that you style weddings to your caliber, you'd look at like 30,000, 35,000 for 50 guests. That sounds about right. Yeah.
So that's just the starting point. That is not necessarily including accommodation for 50 guests, because again, that can be an add-on cost depending how long they want to stay and these kind of things.
Yeah. Okay. Lovely. So for the wedding only costs. Okay. Lovely. I know that's a really difficult question to answer, so I appreciate you answering it, but I hope that everyone understands that it's like asking how long is a piece of string. We can make a budget work, you know, and budgets are very, very flexible, very, very wide ranging. So just a disclaimer to everyone who's watching.
What you have in mind, and then we as planners, we see how we can bring that to life and where we might need to tweak it a bit, right? So
absolutely. So staying in the operational side of things then, and staying with my fantasy wedding, let's say, so I'm British, how would I go about having a legal wedding in Puglia? And actually, do you even recommend that you do that? Because but in Portugal, I don't recommend it. It's a headache. It's not worth doing. And we do symbolic ceremonies instead. So how do you feel about the registering to marry process in Italy in general and Puglia specifically?
It's pretty straightforward if you follow the steps. I mean, it wouldn't be Italy if there wouldn't be paperwork involved. Mm-hmm. So there is. But there are basic paperwork such as your birth certificate, certification if you've been married previously or not, that there is no legal obstacles against your marriage. I would say there would be, like, if you're doing a civil marriage, there'll be like 6 documents involved, and then if you're doing a religious marriage, there's obviously like the baptism,
pre-cana,
certifications, yeah. confirmation certifications, but it's doable. But you do need to have some prep beforehand. If you have a planner, it would be amazing if you can just hand over and they will guide you through it. And if not, it's still possible. Like if you Google it, you can find all the steps. But you need to incorporate some time to at least get the documents from your own embassy, and then it needs to go through to the comune, as they say, the area where you get married, or the church in that case. So it's definitely doable. If you do have, for example, a civil ceremony, and you say, look, we can get legally married for the law in the country where we are, it does obviously make the whole thing a bit more easier. But it's not that it's not possible. I mean, in the end, it's a European country, and they're open for all marriages. They're open for all religions, and same-sex marriage as well, which I'm happy as a Dutch person, which we're born under the first, I'm very happy that finally in Italy that is open too. So, yes.
Fabulous. And so all religious weddings are legal. You can have there as well. That's fascinating. Yeah. In Portugal, it's just Catholic weddings. So it's really interesting. You still have to have a civil ceremony. If you wanted like a Jewish ceremony, for example, you'd have to have a civil for the legal bit, and then your Jewish ceremony is symbolic.
That's the only thing for the Catholic Church, is that they do require a civil marriage certificate. Mm-hmm. For that. That is true. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Fascinating. Cool. So let's land on some places to look at, some towns and some venues and some nice pretty places. So we love a good venue. Tell us about the venues in Puglia. What can we expect? Paint me a picture of what a Puglia wedding could look like in terms of the space and those surroundings.
I'm super excited and eager to tell you. Puglia has some very signature venue style, which I love, honestly. There's the masseria, or one is a masseria, which is kind of like a fortified farmhouse. So old traditional, but usually beautifully restructured. They're often or very white plastered or in terracotta colors. So they're very idyllic backdrop for weddings, and really gives that authentic feeling as well. Next to the Masseria, they have a certain area in the Bari region where they have the tulis, which is kind of like an old, I'd like to compare it sometimes to the gnome houses, which is not really, you know, the gnome houses is not really, sound not really cool, but it is really cool because it's like the white stone huts with the gray roofs. I don't know if you know them, you've seen them. And they can be stunning as well. There is a Masseria Greco that I really love in Ostuni that has like the perfect balance between both those little houses as well as like the beautiful Masseria structure. That's gorgeous, but like those Masari, you find them everywhere and they pop out like mushrooms literally everywhere. So this more south region of Puglia, like Ostuni, Fasano, even in Lecce, there's loads around that you can find. I love, for example, Borgo Ignazia. It's a bit more high-end. It's literally like you walk into this old white little town, but then they turned that into a luxury resort. So it's like the authentic Puglia's experience with a touch of luxury. So that is very, very dreamy. What else? You have the Torre Coccaro. Sorry, my pronunciation is not always great, but very picturesque with the white and the red contrast. Super like Instagrammable, if you ask me. It's a beautiful oasis, and it's also close to the beach. So even if you if you can have a beach wedding, not necessarily in the Masseria, but if you say I offer a beach wedding, you can still have the rural experience, or the other way around. If you say, well, we want to have this rural experience in the Masseria or in the Trulli area, but then we want to, you know, incorporate a beach day as well after, or you want to go sailing afterwards. There's islands in front of the coast of Puglia as well, so you could do a day trip, and it's stunning, really. Yeah. I'll try to link up a couple of other venues, because there's just too many to mention, but
that sounds amazing. It sounds cool that you can kind of create an entire experience that incorporates so much in one place. Yes. That's really cool. I think that if people who are maybe from stateside and coming to Europe, or even within Europe, can just get a bit of everything, a bit of the history, a bit of the beach side, a bit of the countryside, and that's really appealing. That sounds really, really great.
A real Dolce Vita experience, as we say.
Yeah, that sounds wonderful. When we will link to those venues in the description box down below for anyone who is interested in them. But thank you so much for walking us through what we can expect getting married in Puglia. It sounds wonderful. I'm sure everyone who is watching agrees with us. So where can people find you if they want to get in contact and plan a Puglia wedding?
Absolutely. Well, they can find me at the Init Group, the-initgroup.com. You can follow me on social, both Facebook and Instagram. Handle is the Init Group Milano, as Milano is our base. My email address, my contact, send me a DM. I would love to chat and get to know your followers, and see if we can help them make that vision come true.
Lovely. So we'll also add your links on screen, and they are also all linked in the description box down below and in the top comment. And thank you so much for your time, Tissy. And thank you to everyone who's watching. If you have any questions for Tissy, then do get in contact with her with the links down below. And we will see you again soon. Take care. Thank you so much.
Ciao. Bye. Have a lovely day.